Alex Uwe and I were talking. Alex lives in Malaysia. I'm in Portland, Oregon. You know, Malaysia is just down the street. We're talking about helping people with Excel. And I figured this is an important topic to talk about. So this video won't have a whole lot of Excel. It'll be more, you know, context and thinking about how we work. See, a lot of the comments that I get on my videos, they say, Oz, you made that look so easy, so beautiful. But I might have thought about it for 2 days and experimented. So from 2 days of thinking to then maybe a 20-minute raw video, and then I edit it down to 5 minutes, and then it does look easy. And that misleads a lot of people. And I bring this up for a number of reasons. If solutions take you longer than 5 minutes, that's fine. I can't make you a 2-day video where you get to see me walk around, think, and experiment. You get the final thing once I've figured it out. So give yourself permission to take 2 days, a week to figure things out. If you are somebody who can figure something out in 5 minutes, let other people know. Take your time. Give yourself permission. Take the weight off. And then there are the folks who need help, whether they're a client or a student or a friend asking for a favor. It takes time to understand what's going on in situations before we can get to the solution. I have felt the frustration from people who decided they want to have me help them figure out something. And then after an hour, I'm still asking them questions and I can feel their frustration that, you know, the magic didn't happen in 10 minutes. There was one time somebody asked for some help. He's saying all this stuff. I'm asking questions. And after about 5 minutes, he called me a dumb old boob. Now, this was years ago. Back when I was mean, I was meaner than a crocodile with a toothache. I was so mean, my own shadow was scared of me. I didn't have a shadow until about 5 years ago when I calmed down and got straightened out. The guy called me a dumb old boob. Then some stuff happened, and now there's a warrant for my arrest in Arizona. But that was back in the old days. Let's focus back on Excel. So let's do some Excel, and I'm gonna take you back to a situation. A friend posted that she needed to put 7 rows between every row of data in a spreadsheet. And people kept coming up with VBA solutions. And she resisted the VBA solutions because, one, she didn't understand them. She tried the obvious thing. Just start at the top and insert the 7 rows between each row. And she had over 2,000 rows of data. And she got to maybe 50. Said, this is some baloney. But she didn't say baloney. So here I've got this data. Right, I've got, this goes down to row 194. She posted it one afternoon, came back the next morning, still no solution outside of these VBA solutions. I got up, brushed my teeth, and while I'm standing there in the mirror, now I had a reflection by this time. I still didn't have a shadow, but I did have a reflection. And that is when a solution hit me. It was not fancy, but it worked. So let's get into this. Now, first of all, we want to sort these birthdays, right? We want to sort this by the birthday, the day in the month, not the year. So we're going to do that first. Equals text, open parentheses, text of what value? right there, comma. What do we want? We want double quote, month, period, day, double quote, close parentheses, enter. All right, 219, good. Double click, and then I'm gonna go to data and sort. And now we see these three people, Willow, Miguel, and Julie, all have the same birthday of January 18th. All right, now, how did I get seven rows in between each of these rows? This is gonna be one. And then we need seven in between, so that would be the eighth. So then Philly Castile would be row nine. Gotta add eight to that, 17. I'm gonna highlight here, drag this down, and notice that pattern stays. Double click it. Go all the way down. The biggest number is 1,537. Now I'm gonna go back to the top, equals. I'm gonna use sequence. How many rows of data? 1,537, comma, one column, comma, start at one, step one, enter. I'm gonna highlight this, right click, drag, drag, copy here as values only. You see what's about to happen. Let's put this into a table. I'm gonna call this the index. Home. Okay. No filter buttons. Equals XLOOKUP. Lookup what? Lookup this number. Comma. Lookup array. The index column, comma, return the name, comma. If not found, we're not worried about that. I am just going to hit enter. Boom. Timpani Raskin. Double click. So now I'm going to go back and do the if not found. Comma. If not found, stay blank. Enter. Look at it. Beautiful. That was it. Took just a few minutes to implement, but about a half day to think about and also resist my urge to come up with something fancier than this, because I got caught up with the people who were doing the VBA solutions. I wanted to impress them more than I wanted to get my friend a solution. This is the solution she went with. It worked. She understood it. She could be responsible for it. She could replicate it. Now, if you want, you can go ahead and grab those birthdays, but you got the point. And remember, don't ever call anybody a dumb old boo.